Okay, good morning, everybody. Good for you to join today. We're gonna go over unit two. We're gonna do the unit two overview today. So we're gonna look at our unit's topic and our writing project and our speaking project and all the things that we're gonna focus on in this unit, okay? So it is important, there's a lot of information going on today. So it's important that you ask questions or definitely write down the questions that you have so you can ask them later on or maybe even afterwards. Yeah. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to share with you the schedule that we have for this unit. So here we see we have the unit schedule. Let me move this upwards. Okay, so we're having here the grade 11 schedule. So you see here in week one, this is where we're at right now. Today you would be starting with your project planning. Remember that the yellow, the highlighted parts are the planning of your project. So your writing project, your speaking project. Your speaking project is your speaking test. Your writing project is your essay. Now, so this week you would start, the first step is to brainstorm for your speaking test topic and brainstorm for your essay topic, okay? And the other thing that you have to do this week is your pre-study, which is watch the video that I already sent you before the Galungan holiday. I already sent you the link of the video, which is on YouTube, and I already told you to answer or the questions or do the activities in your textbook for listening and speaking, listening part, listening one. That's the one you were supposed to do. If you haven't done it yet, no problem. You can still do that this week. I just gave it faster because sometimes there are students who would like to work ahead. So there is no post study for it this week. Okay, cool. Now, so what you should do is think about your projects. Do not postpone your work until the last minute. If you do so, the problem is that you probably have forgotten all the instructions, you don't know what to do anymore, and you have to do it last minute, whereas a project takes time and has stages. Now, as you can see here, the weeks are all divided already, and that brings us to the week of task submission and testing. That is in the week of the 9th of November, and so you can see that unit 2 is the last unit, the second and the last unit of the semester. We were supposed to do 4, but because of this current situation, we only get to do 2, which is okay. So for you guys, that will be Wednesday the 11th, yeah? I guess see that I haven't placed that in yet. Wednesday the 11th. Yeah, exactly. Wednesday. Let me put it in this way. That would be 11-11. That's an interesting number, yeah? Okay, so that will be Wednesday the 11th, where you will have your unit 2 test. For listening and speaking and reading and writing, basically like that. And you're not submitting your ebook because your ebook is basically already done throughout these 2 months. So you just do it. You just make sure that by the 11th of November, the ebook activities for listening and speaking and reading and writing are all completed. Yeah, I do not open them straight away. I open them per week. Okay, so you have a division on how to work in it. And then on Wednesday the 11th, you are supposed to submit your log, your speaking test, the link of your speaking test. In this case, now it is a speech. You will give a speech, so it's individually done, not in a group. You give a speech about overcoming an obstacle or challenge. And it's not going to be a persuasive speech, it's just an informative speech, okay? So you're not gonna persuade something. So that you take a video, make a video off, not an audio video. Remember that for the ebooks, if there's any recording, it's all audio, never video. For the speaking test, it's always video. And for your reading and writing, you will submit your journal, and that is going to be a biographical essay about a person who has overcome an obstacle. So in your speaking test, you just talk about overcoming obstacles and challenges in general. So you're not going to tell a story about someone. No, you're just going to talk about overcoming an obstacle or challenge, overcoming difficulty. Yeah, and we all have difficulties. So for example, overcoming the difficulty or obstacle of social distancing in this time of the pandemic. Like, there's so many obstacles right now, obstacles in education, obstacles in healthcare, obstacles in business, in so many ways. So you could talk about that, for instance, like what is an obstacle and what is a challenge, and give an example of an obstacle and challenge and how to overcome it. Now, for your essay, you're writing a biographical essay, and we're going to talk about that today, a little bit about what a speech is like and what a biographical essay is like. So it means that you're writing about someone else's life. If it is an autobiography, you're writing about your own life, but you're writing about someone who has overcome an obstacle. So in your essay, you will give the background information about the person, but also what he or she has overcome. Okay, so that's definitely, that's the week or the month when you have to submit. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go look at our textbook first to see what it is that we are supposed to do. So if you can flip your page with me to, okay, I'm going to check. Page 50 for listening and speaking. Now we're talking about listening and speaking first, okay? This is your final speaking test. In this activity, you will prepare a speech about an obstacle. Here it says you have overcome or a challenge you have faced. So in this case, you're not talking about someone else. In your writing, you are talking about someone else. But in this one, you can talk about yourself. In your essay, you will talk about someone else. So For your speech, you will inform about what an obstacle and challenge is and how we have that. And then you can give your speech surrounding your obstacle that you faced in this time of this pandemic right now. Yeah, we're talking about this current time, as in this, the life, how the new normal is right now and how you dealt with it. I'd like you to use the vocabulary, grammar, pronunciation, listening, and speaking skills that we've learned in this unit. You got to use that. So for the grammar and for the vocab, remember, you can just dip into the back of your book and see what the vocabulary is for this unit, right? And you can look at page 211 for that and page 213. Just go to the back of your book to see. Now, here are a few steps. The first one here is use the information in the left column of the chart below to plan a 2 to 3 minute speech. Well, I have given you the instruction. I will give you the instruction in Moodle, which I will upload everything. I will upload the PPT, the summary that I give, and the instruction for your speaking test and all that. Will all be in Moodle. And so you will know exactly how to do it. But these instructions are also in your ebook. So you could also just access your ebook to know exactly how to do your speech, how long it's gonna be, and so on. Yeah. So this you could use for your brainstorming. So remember that the first thing you do is you come up with a brainstorm, right? The background, the challenge, the outcome, the life lesson. These are components that have to be in your speech. So you got to give a background information about yourself and describe the setting of your story and challenge, give a description of the obstacle challenge that you faced. Here you could also talk about what an obstacle or challenge actually is. And then the outcome, so how you dealt with it and what happened. And the life lesson is basically what you learned from it. Yeah, what what it resulted into. And so this is really good to use as your brainstorm, because this kind of guides you to get the ideas. Now you would be thinking, Sylvie, if I'm going to give a speech about myself, how I overcame an obstacle or challenge in my life right now in this time of this pandemic, starting from March until now, so then I don't need to do research. That's not right. You still have to do research, because I told you before that research has two main goals. The first goal is you want to get information that you can use in your talk, in your speaking, and in your writing. But the other reason why we do research basically is because we want to know more about the topic. So you can research, for instance, to understand what is an obstacle or a challenge. You can research on what is a speech? How do I make a speech? What kind of speeches are there? I can do research on people who overcame obstacles. I can do a research on the obstacles and challenges during this time of the COVID-19 pandemic. See, there's a whole lot that you can research on. And maybe you don't necessarily use that information in your speech, but it will help you better understand what you're supposed to do. And it will help you to better create a better speech to give. So that is why you still have to do research, okay? And then, of course, you will record your speech. So you will still, you do your brainstorm. This is a good one. Make sure that these components are definitely in your speech. And then you will, with your brainstorm, do a research to do more information on what speeches or what challenges and obstacles are, or what the obstacles and challenges are in this pandemic, people who have gone through obstacles and have overcome. And then with all that information, you're going to write your outline, your speaking outline for your speech, and then you're going to record it and do the bibliography with the MLA system, and you do the reflection. Okay? Okay. Wait, I need to make a note. Something I forgot. Okay, awesome beans. Any questions so far? Okay, I'm just going to continue then. I'm going to go to the other book. So go with me to the other textbook. Where are you at? This one? No. Okay, I'm going to try and see the other book. Okay, yeah. Okay. So here we are with this is the reading and writing, right? The reading and writing book, which is about facing life's obstacles. The first one is the Achilles heel, something known as it being super strong, and this one is facing life's obstacles. So really in Unit 2, we're talking about difficulties that we face in life and how we deal with it. Here, if we look at the picture, you see he says, builders of boys, makers of men. Now, this is a basketball game that's not so special. We all know that. But the cool thing is here that not everybody has legs, as shows this picture. And the other guys who do have legs, they cannot walk. So for guys in a wheelchair to be able to play basketball is definitely amazing. And that is definitely facing life's obstacles. Not saying, even though I can't walk, I can't play a game. That's super amazing. Now, if we go back real quick to the book we were just now, the one for listening and speaking, right? We were here talking about the Achilles heel. Now, here we can see a man doing What is he doing? He's skiing, right? He has no legs. But he's skiing. So that is just mind-blowing. So what we can see here, the title of this unit refers to the Greek hero Achilles, whose one weakness was in his heel. Now, the expression of Achilles' heel can refer to problems or obstacles that people face in their lives. Now, what kinds of challenges do you predict this unit will be about? So it talks about a weakness, but it also shows that people don't stop there. They don't allow themselves to be, you know, limited just because there are obstacles in life. So we have many kinds of obstacles, physical, economic, mental, social. There are a lot of different types of obstacles. So a lot of people just think about, you know, having a problem with your body, or, but there are so many different types of obstacles that we're facing in our life, right? Okay, with this one, we're going to look at our writing. Yeah, I'm just pacing through because I want to make sure that all of you get to understand them. We do not have that much time. So we straight away cut to the chase. We go to page 55. So if you can go to page 55 with me, here you go. Here we have the final writing test. That is your essay. Here it says paragraph, but you're not gonna write a paragraph. You are gonna write an essay, of course. So yeah, you're gonna write, read about personal accounts, stories of people who overcame obstacles. It's really motivating. Now you're gonna write a biographical essay about how you, not you, you're gonna write about someone, not you. And I said that already just now. Here it says you can write about how you or someone you know overcame an obstacle, but I want you to write about someone else, yeah? If it is you, then it will be autobiographical. Writing about yourself would be autobiography, and I want you to focus on someone else. So you're gonna write an biographical essay, not paragraph, on how someone else, someone you know, or it, you don't have to know the person, you can just pick one, anyone you can pick, giving information about the person and then how the person overcame an obstacle. Yeah, so what you can see here is a form of brainstorm. So listing is a pre-writing activity in which you list information about a topic. So that is basically a brainstorm. Here you have obstacles faced by Frank McCourt and Marla Runyon, and faced by me or someone I know. So you can just pick someone, but not yourself, definitely. Yeah. So do your brainstorm, and then after you've done your brainstorm, you're gonna go into research because you need to find information about this person. You're gonna write a biographical essay, which is still objective. Yeah, it's not a story. Yes, William?
For the someone who overcame the obstacle, that can be anyone, right?
Not like
anyone with like injuries, but people who are like still healthy, but like they passed some hardships, they can do that.
Yep. Okay. Any former presidents, anyone, it doesn't matter. Okay. Yeah. So after you've done your brainstorm, you do your research because you need to get information about the person. And then you will, you use your brainstorm to do the research. Maybe you can add information while you do your research, and then you write your outline. And after you've done your outline, you write it. Yeah. Remember to put all the sources, MLA system, in your bibliography, and then write your reflection. Yeah. So a biographical essay describes a person's life and sometimes focuses on one particular aspect. So you're not doing a paragraph, you're doing an essay. So introduction, body, and conclusion. Yes? Let me see, this gives you information. Checklist, I'm looking for a checklist. Now here you have a checklist. Does the essay describe a person? And so on and so on and so on. Just make sure all is in it, but regarding an essay, not a paragraph. Okay, so I'm gonna jump into biography. I'm gonna go over a few things. I will also give you, I found this one. This is actually very good. And I want you to look at it. So I'm going to post all of it and then you can read it by yourself. Yeah. So basically, a biography itself is just when you're writing about someone's life, but you're going to do a combination. You're going to write about someone's life, but your focus in the person's life will be the obstacle. So you do talk a little bit about things like childhood, education, and current situation. So your focus at first is childhood, when they were born and all that. And then that will evolve and the time after, what happened, their education, and the obstacle that took place, and then up till the current time as how they have dealt with it and what their life is like now. So So a biography is an account of someone's life written by another person. If it is written, if you write about yourself, then you're doing an autobiography, right? So biography is defined as a story written about someone's life. This means that the first key to writing a biography is to choose your subject. So that is the first thing in your brainstorm you got to do, is choose a good topic, subject. Where are you going to write about? So it doesn't have to be anyone from Indonesia. It can be anyone from anywhere. Maybe you can pick a person that you're interested in, a subject that you really would like to know about. So you explore the events in that particular person's life and find the meaning within it. Like, but remember that your research is based on an obstacle. So remember that you have a more specified part. You do write about their life, but you're basically looking for the obstacle they had. Now you have short biographies. Those are more basic life facts, but this is a longer biography in which you're going to write 5 paragraphs. You're gonna go an extra mile, you include more details. And in this case, you're focusing more on the obstacle, what the obstacle was, why the person got it, and how they overcame. Your biography has to be engaging, means that it's interesting to read it, okay? You write it in an interesting way, but it's an informative. So that means it's based on facts. You got to do research. So you're not going to tell a story. You're informing, but still make it interesting to be read. Make sure you have included all the material. Make sure you have researched it. Now, one of the important things that have to be included is a great title. That can be decided after you're done. You don't have to start with a title. You can just write your biography first, the essay first, and then later on come up with the title. But remember that it must reflect a character, yeah, as a thesis statement. So your title must be connected with the subject, the person, and the thesis statement. Is there a thesis statement? Yeah, it's a biographical essay. It's not an article, it's an essay. So there, you still have the introduction with your HOT, your hook, your overview, your thesis, your body, 3 body paragraphs, and your conclusion, which you conclude and summarize. So there's some significant information going on. Ensure that you have gathered enough information. So make sure that you do good research, brainstorm well, research, add information, and then you can pick ones you want to use. The ones you say, not really nice, you can kick them out. It's like writing actually a summary about someone's life. It's as if you're just, you're not writing about every detail, meaning that you gotta really only pick the important parts. Don't talk about every tiny detail. Yeah. Just make sure that whatever you're sharing is clear and makes sense. Yeah. Awesome beans. Now I'm gonna show you another one. I don't know when this one does not pop up. No, we do not want that. Let's see if that one pops up. Okay, there's another one I'd like to show you. Stop sharing. Okay, this one is basically a compilation of biography, autobiography, and memoir. So as we remember that a biography is writing about someone else's life, an autobiography, we're writing about our own life. The memoir is something written about someone else, but this is short information. So this is just good for you to go through, read through it just for yourself to get more information. Knowing that the biography is nonfiction. So remember, we've got fiction and nonfiction, and it is not fiction. Meaning a fiction is a story with a storyline, with a plot. Everything that's nonfiction means it's not a story, doesn't have a plot. So it's informative. It gives you information, right? So that's basically biography falls under nonfiction, which we now call as informative texts, yeah? So it's there, it tells a story of a person's life or part of a real person's life, yeah? So it can relate to historical events. It also depends on who you choose, yeah? Yeah. So it's a chance for children, for people to know more. Also a chance actually by writing these kind of things that the world knows about what certain people have done in their life, like the impact that they had, maybe the impact they had on music, the impact they had in technology, the impact they had any part of life. So basically we want people to know, yeah? These are just examples. People like biographies because they're interested in it. They want to know more about it. They're interested, especially people who did groundbreaking things in life, right? So you have to have a list of sources, bibliography. Yeah. If you want to, you could put a picture in if you want to do that, a picture of the person you're talking about. That would be cool. Then we know that's very nice to do. Settings are clearly accurately depicted, full interesting social details. Yeah, well, this is basically a PowerPoint that I give you just so you have some background information to go through. Yeah. Then here it explains about what a memoir is. Yeah, this is different, but we're not talking about that. But you have then basically compiled. So plot blends factual background with a good story, distinguishes fact between opinion, it's clear. And well, you're writing a biographical essay, so it's informative, no opinion, yeah, and it shows every part, and that's what makes it actually very interesting if we talk about biography. Yeah, now I'm going to show you a what is that? Wait. How do we get out of this? Let me see. Get out of it this way. Oh, somehow I can get out of this thing. Something happens with my sharing screen. Wait a sec. Wait. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I'm born. Oh, wait. Okay, this is okay. I have another thing that I want to show you. It's a very good example for you. It might just be helpful for you to look through that to understand how to create a biographical essay. It's just some extra information. I'm just helping you out to get an idea. Yeah, so you have also a narrative, you also have biographical narratives, you have those too, and those are a bit different because a biographical essay is more informative, more objectively written, whereas a biographical narrative is written in story form. So if you have a biographical narrative, you're using the first POV, the first person point of view, and it's more written lively and story-like. But if it's a biographical essay, we are more formal and informative, and therefore we use the third POV. Yeah, I hear it explains about the introduction, Here it gives you an example of the notes, pre-writing, the steps of you gather information, draw a conclusion, write your thesis. This is an example how you do your drafting. Yeah, so it's the first time you write introductions, support the thesis, write a conclusion. Now, here you have an example. This is a biographical essay about George Washington. Yeah. And then you have the part of revision where you can revise your thesis or the language you use. And this is like a rubric of self-assessment about the organization, the presentation, and the use of your language. I'm giving you this because I see that this is good. It gives you some ideas of how you could do it. But remember that your biographical essay, yes, is about a person of choice, but your focus is on how they overcame an obstacle. You got to remember that though, yeah? That is your focus. So you're, see, in a biography, you can talk about a lot of things. In your case, you're talking about an obstacle. Any questions about that? Now we're gonna look into informative speaking. This one is about a speech, informative. You're gonna give an informative speech. You're not gonna give a persuasive speech. You have different types of speeches, okay? People's speech can be persuasive. Speech can just be informative, and yours is gonna be informative. Yeah, so in this case, you present the information in ways that will help your audience to understand and remember what they're hearing. Your speech is informative because in this case, you're gonna tell about yourself and you're gonna tell about something you overcame, right? An obstacle you overcame. So you're telling, informing and telling, but you're not persuading. If you're persuading, you're giving an opinion about something and you want people to either act in a certain way or do something, the thing that you would want them to do. But in an informative speech, you're telling, but not with the points to get someone to do something, just because you want them to know. So an informative speech, no matter what you are informing your audience of, the content is very important. How the content is delivered is also important because people need to understand and need to be interested. So make sure that you deliver it lively. Yeah. You only have one chance, so you make sure that everybody understands. They cannot rewind, so make sure that you're clear. You'll get this PowerPoint so you can read through it yourself. It's an informative speech, so you should take a topic that interests and is familiar. Now, your topic is already chosen for you. You write about an obstacle you faced and you overcame, or you're still in. That's fine, too. And I'd like you to talk about an obstacle related to this pandemic. Yeah. So your speech is not going to be too long. It's about 5 to 7 minutes. So you have time. It doesn't have to be 7 minutes. Yeah. So don't make it too long and broad. Make sure that you can finish it within the time. So your speech is going to be expository speech because you're going to inform. As you have exposition, persuasive, argumentative, narrative, and descriptive, your speech is expository because you're giving information, yeah? Should analyze, yeah, make sure that you give it in an interesting way, still give the information, but in a way that will attract your audience, okay? So basically everybody knows about this pandemic, so make sure that you make your speech so about you, what your challenge was and how you're dealing with or overcame, or maybe you didn't ever come it yet, maybe you're still dealing with it, but be very informative about it so it is attractive. Yeah. Okay, if you think your topic speech is going to give your audience a duh reaction, try a different perspective. So make sure that people are not bored. That's what I meant just now. So what is your organization? The main parts of a good speech is the same as a good essay. Okay, so three main parts you already know. Got an introduction, got the body, and the conclusion, just like an essay. So the first thing you do is you want to capture your audience interest. So we use a hook, okay? Remember that? That can be a statement, a question. Get their interest, yeah, that's related to their experience in life. So they go like, okay, get that. And the thesis states the goal of the purpose of your speech. So you've got your, basically here, we've got the H for hook, the O for overview, and the thesis. So which is the topic and the purpose. Three main ways you can organize the main points of your speech. You can use chronological order, you can use logical order, and you can use spatial order. Now, if we're using spatial order, this one is referring to descriptive. When you're describing something, then we use spatial order. Logical order or order of importance is mostly used for informative things. So which is most important or logical to place it in the right order. Chronological order mostly is used for stories, but also when we talk about experiences. So spatial order is not the one you will use, but I think the one you can use, which is good for you to use, is probably either this and or this. Now, I think better logical order, yeah? But it can be that you're talking about an experience, right? About how you face an obstacle. So it might be that chronological order works. So chronological order is sequence. First, then, after that, following that, finally. Whereas logical order is, yeah, more into the first thing that happened as well, following, but this is more into that. So this shows more time. So it's up to you how you use it, or you use them both. Yeah? Next. So for expository, so we have we do not use logical order. You're going to use this method of organization if you're supplying basic information. Logical order is also categories. Spatial order, as I said just now, describing. So you're not describing, so we don't use that. But if you're doing, I missed the other one. Oh, yeah. Okay, sorry. Skip. Alrighty. Okay, we come to the conclusion of the speech. He's hanging. Okay. So refer to the introduction, you give a quote, anecdotes. Now the delivery is also important. This is an important part for you. How will you present your information? Extemporaneously, you give it really full of excitement, okay? Expressively, okay? So it is an outline to be heard, not memorized. You use an outline or note cards. You can use cue cards, are also called note cards, but you cannot read, because if you do something extemporaneous, means that you're very expressive. So when you start reading, you're not expressive. Yeah. So you're more spontaneous, you're excited, you connect with your audience. So beware, use it as cues to hold, but you cannot read word for word. So you do not look down at your cards, you do not read them, okay? It's important. Well, you're making a video, so that must be okay. Okay, mnemonic, memory devices to help you sell the audience, remember your main points. So that could be parallel structure, acronyms, using images helps people to remember. Mnemonic is to remember. Another thing is, I see what you see, I hear what you look like. That's important. Is it interesting? I see what you see and I hear what you look like. Which means that what the listeners see and hear that affects how they think about the content. So what they see and hear is what, that's what will make their opinion about it. So you want to look good, and you want to look, you want to make sure that your speech is right and that it gives the right information. Okay, so there are delivery strategies. You can go with that. Use your voice effectively. So we're talking tone, rate, and volume. Make sure of that, and make sure that your video is clear, yeah? Enunciate clearly, yeah? So I can hear you. Do not overpronounce. Avoid vocalized pauses, like unlike, and so on. And no boss intonation, yeah? Be enthusiastic. Audience will respond to excitement. Strategies, like, for example, look nice. I had one that was in their boxers. We don't do boxers. You're on a video, so make sure you dress appropriately and neat. Yeah. Maintain eye contact. That's why, even though it's a video, you have to have eye contact. If you don't, I will lessen your score. Yeah. Facial expressions, hand gestures, important. Use good posture. Stand up straight, not leaning to or against the wall. So make sure that your video, you're making a video, that it is clear, okay? Okay, you can use visual. If you want to use a visual, that is fine, to just make it a better to enhance your speech. Okay, let me see. And go through this. Finally, practice. And make sure in the last final, rehearse to establish, to make it better. Okay, so these are just some of the information that I'm giving you to help you do your project. Do you have any questions about it? Any questions? No. Okay, the descriptions of how to write your essay and to do your speech are all in your ebook also. Not yet. I will do that today. So you can access that there and at Moodle, and make sure that you do everything in time. And I told you this is a project, it will take time. So over time you can still ask me questions. Okay, no one wants to ask, so then I assume that everybody understands. That's awesome. And then later on, everybody comes with chats. You can also form study groups, basically, where you take time to sit together, or not sit together, virtually get together. To talk about this and do it together. That's totally fine. Even though this is an individual task, both the speech and the biographical essay, but as a group, you can make it together to help each other. Yeah. Okay, then. Thank you very much. Okay, Joseph, what is it, Justin?
For journal, you write a biography, right? And then for speaking, we make a speech about ourselves.
Yeah, that's correct. So your essay is about someone else. Yeah, and the biography. So you write about someone else and how the person, what obstacle they had and how they overcame. And I will give you the outline of your, I will inform you on the outline of your essay, so you know how to write it. Yeah, how to structurize it. That will be in the instruction. And for your speaking, you do speech about yourself, how you overcame an obstacle or what obstacle you face and how you're dealing with it. Correct. Anything else? No? Okay, cool beans. Great. Okay, I will see you again next week. Remember, you gotta do your pre-study, watch the video, do the activities in your textbook for listening and speaking, and do the brainstorming for your speech and also for your essay this week. So next week, you already have a topic, you already have done a brainstorm, and then you can jump into research next week. You do it step by step, okay? Awesome. Okay, have a great day, guys. God bless you. Bye-bye.